Hey everybody, welcome back. Today we're going to be doing another coaching session for League of Legends. This is going to be a Thresh game. Now, unfortunately, I could not access the op.gg for this. I tried a bunch of different ways to figure out what this name is, how to spell this. I tried it with the spaces. I tried I's instead of L's everywhere where an I looks like an L. I could not figure it out how to spell this. So I did my best, but I'm going to talk about just in general, what should be happening here in terms of runes, itemization, wards, and then we'll just see it unfold as the game goes on. So it's not a big deal. So you should aim for one control ward every 5 minutes. That's kind of a bare minimum. You want to try to get more than that. So like a 30-minute game, 6 control wards minimum, and then one normal ward per minute on average. So 30-minute game, 30 wards. I recommend the following runes for Thresh. You want to run AD reds, health yellows, and armor quints. This will give you some survivability. You have to have the 80 reds to help you last hit with Targons. Health yellows are just the best kind of early game stat that you can get. If you don't have the IP for yellows, I mean, it's going to change in 2 weeks anyways, but that's just like right now, that's the ideal. And then as far as blue goes, if you're against a harassment early laner like a Sona or a Nami or a Lulu or something like that, you can take magic resist blues. But if you're against Janna, you can get away with taking CDR blue, and that opens up your build path a little bit more. It allows you to get to 40, pretty close to 40% CDR. It's going to give you 7.5% CDR, which will round up to 8. And that means you only have to have 3 CDR items to basically get to the cap. So that's going to free you up to be able to get things like mobility boots and lock it without having to worry about missing out on the CD. Whereas if you don't have that CDR, you're going to have to get more CDR oriented items. Like you might have to get a Zeke's, Ionian boots, or something like that, because 40% CDR is very important on Thresh. Excuse me, for how his kit works. Let me drink water here real quick. I'm talking a lot all day. Okay, so a nice build order would be something like Ruby Sightstone, Face of the Mountain. And you can kind of choose from there. You can go Zeke's if your AD carry is really far ahead. Knight's Vow is a good choice. Remember that Thresh only gets half benefit out of that, though. So, you know, he's only going to redirect 6% of damage and heal for 6% of what his target heals for. Or Locket. Locket's actually a pretty good choice because there's a cannon in the game at some point. So you could go Ruby Face Locket if you want, and that wouldn't be that bad. If Talon gets fed on the enemy team, then maybe a Zeke's would be good because that does give you 60 armor and it gives you gives you the CDR, and it also gives you that that steroid for your AD carry, which they just buffed a couple of patches ago to make it basically 25% extra damage on hit instead of 15% extra damage on hit. As far as masteries go, I would make sure you have Courage of the Colossus, and then Bandit, and just kind of be standard masteries. Okay. In terms of the pregame, you should try to make plays against Janna and Xayah early. They're going to outscale Lucian, but Lucian has a lot of kill threat, especially because you have Ignite. So just be as aggressive as you can. See if you can land those flays and hooks. Make some plays. Just make sure that you don't get killed. Nautilus does have really good ganking early on. He has a lot of crowd control, at least. So you want to make sure that until you get really good coverage, that you're always just aware that you might need to have that lantern to get Lucian out of there. Especially if you lose your flash or you use your flash, you need to play really defensively. So just be aware of Nautilus. He's a heavy early ganking jungler. His clear is kind of slow though, and he's not really a threat to take Dragon early. But Yi is a threat to take Dragon early. So you want to try to keep a control ward on Dragon, make sure they don't ward it, and then see if you can get Yi to sneak it. Just be careful for a Akin and teleport, so do not let them keep wards behind you. Always use your sweeper and use more control wards to lock out that vision. Make sure they can't TP on you or make it really hard for them to do so. Because Kennen's very, very dangerous if he gets flanking TPs and ults. So just keep an eye on that. Try to notice and see if he uses his teleport top. but that's really one of the major ways you could lose this lane is if Kennen flanks. Or if Talon roams down. I mean, know that Talon can roam really well too. So you're going to want an early Sightstone. You're going to want lots of control wards to keep tabs on Talon and Nautilus. Because when Nautilus shows up and he just like presses R, there's a high probability that you're going to die if that happens. Unless you're like really fed. So just keep that in mind. You can win the late game pretty easily if you get Master Yi fed. Vayne is also. You have the Vayne, right? No, you had the Lucian. Okay, Vayne was the last game that I coached. Lucian can carry if he gets pretty fed. I don't know the results of this game. I haven't seen the OP.GG. Ziggs can be pretty annoying, but I think your main path to victory is probably Master Yi. Lucian can do it if he gets fed. But these would be the two kind of priority targets, I think. Ziggs can be very impactful, but these two will be the ones that you really want to keep your eye on for a lot of the game. Okay, let's go ahead and get in here. So I'm going to take some physical notes now, and then at the end, we'll bring it all together and see if I can give you the five best tips to help improve your play a little bit. All right, add this in there. And for anyone watching, if you want to get your own coaching session, if you enjoyed this and you want me to help you out with one of your games, you can scroll down to the bottom. I've got my email linked here. It's just thestrategyprofessor@gmail.com. You can find it in the description to this video. You can also find this Google Doc if you want to check that out as well. If you want to watch more coaching sessions, I've got a link here, and I have a link to other individual champion guides that I have. All of this is in the description of the video as well, but I went ahead and put it in the Google Doc because why not? Okay, let's go ahead and get back in here. So speed through the beginning. We'll take off. Put on blue camera ward. I wouldn't invade. I wouldn't invade. I mean, you have a hook, but so does Nautilus. So I wouldn't chance it. I mean, these guys have no crowd control. I don't know why they're. I would have sat here probably early on. If you see that someone else is already going to watch this place, then go down here and watch the tri-bush. You want to get in the habit also of if you're helping on red, try to walk this way. It's just like maybe a half a second slower, but you don't have to walk through the tri-bush if you do that. It's really dangerous. Like Xayah and Janna aren't that much of a threat, but it's just a good habit to get into because if it's like a Blitzcrank Draven or something and they're hiding in that bush, when you walk through there, it's a big deal. And it's easily preventable. It just takes an extra half second just to walk around a little bit more. Okay. Speed this up. You should be trying to auto-attack Janna when she walks up there. Just get a little more aggressive with her. Obviously not when they hit two. There you go, you hit two. You are gonna lose this. You need to. I think you're gonna lose it. Yeah, you need to get out. Yeah, just run. Okay, so let's analyze that. Okay, so in general, you want to lead with your flay at level two. So what you want to do. You need to be hitting Janna when she walks up like that. But what you want to do if you want to go for this play is flay her right here, walk up, and then wait for that shield to go down. Let me pause it. So when you see Janna's shield up, now it's an 18-second cooldown on that shield. So you wait on the shield to go down, and then she's got nothing. So once that shield goes down, you walk up, and then you flay backwards. Like you aim your flay here, and it'll pull the Xayah from here to here and slow her. And then once she's slowed by the flay, then you hit him with the hook. And that's a much higher probability play to make. And you can also do that to Janna. Early on, you're not going to get punished that hard if you miss the flay. They might hit you with one or two autos. Later on, they'll hit you with a lot more damage, so you can't always do the flay hook. But early on, especially level two, that's kind of Thresh's bread and butter, is flay hook. I mean, some Threshes will go as far as to flash onto them and then flay hook them. I don't know if you have to go that far. I think they're out of position enough to where you could just straight up flay them and then hook them. But right here, once you miss that hook and Xayah lands those feathers, you need to ping back because right now Lucian is starting at like 40% health and Xayah is still going to be at 70 or something after this hits. So you need to just ping him back. Like once he starts doing this, you need to ping him back. Just ping him back. Don't let him do that. He's at like 20% health. And they still have exhaust. Like, it looks close, but it's really not that close. So once she chunks you out for that much, you just can't fight anymore. You gotta just run. Okay, so I'm gonna go. Oops. Okay, so ping back after bad trades. Then lead with your E and then your Q. Okay, good job holding as much as you can. Nautilus is probably around topside right now. Yeah, he just pinged this. He just hit the dust there. Or that was cannon. Okay, Nautilus is middle. Alright. So, usually people start blue and then head their way to top, almost always, or they start bot side and go top around 3:30 or 4 minutes. So if they don't come down to try to cheese you at level 2 at like 2 minutes and 30 seconds, usually you can assume they're not going to be there. But he could be anywhere right now. He's likely top lane, because there aren't going to be any more camps bottom side, but they also know that Lucian's flash is down. So it's totally possible they could come down and go for a camp. Okay, that's a good hook. Okay, good. Get those autos in there. Good. Pressure him. Do you have any more pots? You don't need pots. Hit one of these and heal a little bit. There you go. Now go up and thin this wave out. Like, auto attack a couple of minions. Yeah, try to get up on her. You gotta thin this wave out, though, because you guys can't fight in this many minions. Oh. Just auto her at that point. Don't worry about the hook. Okay, good. Yeah, she goofed that up. I would help him push first. So before you back, I know you're kind of low, but so is he. So I would just walk up and flay this minion wave, auto attack it a couple of times, and then just run. Because what's going to happen is right now, Janna's probably going to show up. Yeah, and then if she's smart, she'll hold the wave right here. And I'll watch and show you what this does. Now, she's actually really messing this up. Yeah, so she did not do that correctly. But if she had let it freeze here, it still is going to push, though. So what's going to happen is it's going to deny Lucian this entire wave. Most likely, I think. Yeah. Because there are more minions on this side. So it's going to deny Lucian this cannon minion and this whole wave. Never mind, she's pushing. So they don't know how to manage waves. I'm not sure which elo this is. I wasn't able to look it up. But what happens there, what should have happened, okay, they're actually doing dragon. You see them run out of there? I mean, I can hear it, kind of, you know, cheat sheet here in the replay, but yeah, it should be sending bells off that Xayah just showed up and then backed. and she didn't lose anything for it. So if you push that harder, she would have lost a minion wave if she wanted to go do that. And there's a decent chance she maybe doesn't even, like, go to do dragon because she doesn't want to lose the minions. Yeah, you gotta tell him to chill. Alright, well, it worked out. But yeah, if you had helped him push in the minion wave, then the next wave that was coming in would have crashed into this tower, and it would have reset in the middle of the lane. Oh, that was a nice hook. But yeah, so you want to push. Because what they could have done, they could have just frozen the wave right here and denied you one wave and forced you to come up this far. And then Nautilus, since he wanted to do dragon, could have sat here and, like, ganked you when you came up here. If they were a little more organized. Yeah, like this. This is what you want. You want to push it in and have this going on. Okay, good. Now I notice you're going Stoneborn, so you can go Ardent Censor here. Okay. Ardent Censor's fine on 720, which is what we're looking at it. On 721, I probably wouldn't do it on Thresh. Maybe it's still worth it, maybe, but it's not nearly as tempting as it is on 720. Once those nerfs go through. I think Ardent's still a fine item on standard enchanters. I'm just not sure if it's worth it on Thresh. Maybe it is, but... It's a tougher call on 721, for sure. Okay, but y'all are ahead. I kind of like the Ardent buy. You're not facing heavy damage down here from Janna or anybody. Wait. But why do you have Crystalline Bracer? Are you rushing Redemption? I definitely would not rush Redemption. Ardent, okay. I see the merit in Ardent, but... Yeah, I don't, oh god, for real? I don't like the fake lantern there. The reason is, like, you lose part of your shield and you lose your ability to lantern Lucian out if Nautilus shows up. Now, Nautilus is top right now, but I don't think y'all knew that at the time. Like, the fake lantern is usually used to bluff to scare people when you don't want to fight them. Or to actually lantern someone in. But there's really not a point in faking it unless you're just trying to get a flash. Like, maybe you're trying to burn a flash or something off of somebody. But they're almost never going to flash until they see someone come in on the lantern. So, I wouldn't do it. I mean, there is a time and a place just to throw a random lantern just to keep them guessing. If you think they don't have vision of this bush, you could keep them guessing and maybe they run back. And then they don't know when you're actually going to lantern somebody in. So, you know, there's a little gamesmanship there. There's a little bluffing going on. But I don't think you want to immediately fight after that, because Lantern, even if it's just a shield, is pretty valuable. Like, it can shield you and Lucian, for a decent little chunk. You know, it's at least 50 or something, I think, at this point. Probably a little bit more. But yeah, I mean, it's a decent little shield, and like I said before, if you don't have vision of Nautilus, we don't know where he is right now. you don't have any vision of the river, because you don't have a sight stone yet. So, you know, he very well could just be sitting in this bush. I mean, he could be in this bush. We don't know where he is. I mean, there's no objective to take on the map, so he could be anywhere. So, yeah, you really need to hold on to that lantern. Also, if you hit a hook, if you want to go really aggressive, you can throw the lantern back on Lucian, and that'll get him really close. So that even if they try to flash away, Lucian can probably run him down. So there's just so many things you could do with Lantern other than bluff. You can just shield for the combat effectiveness. You could go really hard and lantern Lucian in once you land a hook. Let him save one of his dashes, or you can play it safe, which is probably what I would do here because you don't know where Nautilus is. Let's watch this again. So it worked out. I mean, it's not like it's the end of the world to use the lantern in that way, but I do like the next level thinking there, where you're trying to set up bluffs. I wouldn't do it if you actually intend on all-inning right there. Just throw it every now and then if you don't really want to fight, but you just want to kind of get in their head a little bit. Okay, good. And y'all push it this time. Yeah, so you push it most of the time. That one time, you were kind of low, and I understand why you just want to back there, but it just takes a moment just to at least flay and auto-attack the minions a couple of times to help Lucian push it. And it could be a big deal. All right, what are you getting now? Redemption. Yeah, I really don't like Redemption Rush here. The reason is you don't even have Wind Speakers, so you're not going to get enough bonus, because you get triple bonus. Like, the base on Redemption's really low. I talked about this in several past videos. I know you're kind of new to the channel, but they nerfed Redemption back in April or May, That's when the Ardent Censor became the standard after they nerfed Redemption for like the third or fourth time. But how it works now is it's really not worth it until you get like 30% plus healing and shielding or so. So you really need the Redemption itself gives 10, and then you really need to get Wind Speakers and one other item to make it worth. The healing's just not going to be enough. It doesn't give you any combat stats. Like, the healing's really low, especially at an early level, like level 7. The healing's probably, like, I don't know, like 170 per person, maybe. Okay, we'll go ahead and use it here. There you go. Need to put it on Lucian a little bit more, too. Talon's coming. Y'all need to leave. Y'all need to leave. They're pinging Talon. Don't go face check it. Right? I mean, where's Talon? That's why they were pinging, right? I mean, let me go back and see. Okay, Talon's full health right now. Wait, they're trolling. Wait, who's pinging back? Is that them or you? I wouldn't run over here. I mean, I guess he has some health, but like, what if Talon just comes like flipping over this wall and just like jumps on Lucian? I mean, I guess you could flay him off, maybe. I don't know. My response would be run, because like Talon, he's not like super fed, but he has 2 kills. Yeah, that's about what I thought was gonna happen. Yeah. Y'all should not have been there. That's what I was thinking. I was like, are y'all gonna get away with that? Like, that seemed extremely dangerous, because Talon's full health. He's still Talon. He has a couple of kills. You've got Kennen right there who has his ultimate. Like, you guys don't have ultimates. You don't have summoners. Lucian was at like 10% health. It's just way too bold. Like, if there's a dangerous mid laner, like a heavy burst mid laner, and you lost sight of him, and your mid laner is pinging back, like, get out of there, you need to just run and just ask questions later. Because now they're going to get Infernal on top of that. So yeah, that was really rough. What do you have now? Moby Boots. You need to get a Sight Stone. Especially against Nautilus. He has such good ganks. I mean, I know y'all are just, like, slaughtering them bottom, but you need to practice and like cultivate healthy habits. Like, even in games where you're really far ahead, play it right. You know, play it by the books. Don't get too cocky about it. No. Run. There's nobody here. There's like 4 people right there. No. Lucian wasn't there. You gotta look at Lucian. Should he have followed? Yes. Did he follow? No. Okay, let me write some of this down really quickly. Yeah. Check menu before engage. Okay, let me look at this really quick. Okay, so all I wrote down was, if the mid laner pings you back, you need to just run and just ask questions later. You know, most people aren't going to ping you if there's not a good reason for it. Like, if anything, people won't ping you enough. So when they do ping you, you really have to listen. And then if there was no reason for it, then take that, you know, into consideration. Say, okay, maybe next time I won't listen to them. But give them the benefit of the doubt. If they ping you back, you got to go back. Look before you engage. Okay, so stop. As soon as you miss that hook, you wait. All right, you're waiting the 14 seconds or whatever it was when you first did it. You wait until it's up. No, no flay. No, you don't have all your tools. Just wait. There's no reason to go in there. Because you're missing an important tool. You don't have vision. Like, you need vision of this up here. You need to at least start buying some more control wards. Like, see if you can get a sight stone. I would have gone probably, like, just see if you could get brown boots plus sight stone. Yeah, it's just, you don't know. You don't know where Nautilus is. Okay, he's teleporting behind you right now. Yeah, y'all need to run. Throw him a... Yeah, there you go. Yeah, remember, that's one of the ways you can lose is cannon. Yeah, okay, good job. Y'all got around that teleport really well. This would be a place where you could throw a lantern or something over there. Like, just... when they come up here, just throw a lantern and then just, like, run at them. That would be a place to fake them. If you want to fake them. No, that's... okay, it worked out, but that's the second time you've done that. So, if you miss your hook, you have to let it go. That's a very important part of your kit. You're under no pressure. You don't have to fight them. Your tower has plenty of health. You could have easily just wave cleared right there. So, it's the same thing over here. You don't have to go for Janna. If you miss the hook, I know sometimes it's frustrating, so you're like, dang it, I missed it, but I still want to get him. You know, but you gotta let it go. You have to wait until your hook's up. If you miss the hook, play's dead. You just gotta wait till your hook's back up. How much CDR do you have? What's that gonna say? You need to push this in and just go heal. Like, you guys are too low. I guess. I mean, they did just back. They're gonna be here about when you finish this, but... Kenan doesn't have teleport, so... okay. Fair enough. It has to be Sightstone right now. This is the latest... you could possibly get it. Okay. I think you're kind of priced into getting Eye of the Equinox. I really don't like that item, but you need 4 wards now. I really like going Face of the Mountain, Ruby Sightstone, but you have to do that a lot earlier. You just can't wait that long on your 4 ward item. Or you could get, I guess you could get Ruby now. That does combo well with Redemption. The thing, like, Redemption used to give much, much higher base healing, but now it's not worth. I think if you guys are this far ahead on 720, as I said before, you got ult or no? A couple seconds. See, that barely. That barely moved the needle. Like, that was such an anemic heal. Yeah, I would have much rather seen you, if you want to go that route, if you want to go for kind of the enchanter item, I would much rather see Ardent Censer. Remember, if you haven't watched me play Ardent Censer on things like Thresh before, the way this works is if you take Stoneborn Pack, the healing that comes off of Stoneborn counts as a heal from you, so it triggers the Ardent passive. It triggers the extra attack speed and on-hit damage for anybody who attacks a person that has that rune over their head. That's what I thought you were setting up for. That's reasonable if you're ahead and you don't, you know, think you're going to be taking that much damage. You can rush that item. But yeah, now you're squishy without enough payoff, I think, with Redemption, so... what do you have now? Are you going Ardent right now? I don't know about 2 enchanter items. I think one's cute. One can work. I think Ardent specifically can work, but... if you want more buffs at this point, just get Zeke's. Zeke's is a buff, but it's also a tank item. That Zeke's would actually be really good here because Talon is so fed. If he catches you out, like, in the jungle warding or something, he's gonna murder you. You have no armor items. Like, not a single armor item. And Thresh has really low base armor. No, 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 do not follow that. Do not follow that. Just not strong enough. The thing is, Redemption has a really high fail rate too. People just run out of Redemption all the time. And Kennen's gonna... Well... Yeah, so Redemption has a fail rate. People can't run out of Ardent Censer, but they can run out of Redemption, you know? Alright. Master Yi, I thought was getting some good kills. Oh, Ziggs got that. Nice. Teemo's getting pretty fed. Okay. So what I was talking about here with this dive, the reason I said don't go in on that is because you don't have any armor. Like, if you had, like, Face of the Mountain Zeke's or something like that. Like, if you had some kind of armor or even locket, then you could safely make that play. But, like, diving this far when you didn't... I don't believe you had vision on the flanks at that point. I mean, let me go back and just look at it. Like, when you are a... when you're going this kind of Enchanter-ish Thresh, which, like I said, I don't recommend two Enchanter items... But even assuming that you wanted to go, like, Ardent Censer Thresh. Yeah, you didn't have vision on the flanks. Yeah, you didn't have vision here. You don't have vision here. There are four people missing right now. You have to see the unseen. Okay, now this is getting low. Okay, so there's nobody here. Like, they were here, but they just disappeared. So they're probably rotating. So it's like, pop quiz, where are people? Ask yourself. So there's no one here marking this tower right now. There's no one marking Teemo top lane. Nobody on Raptors. Nobody, they wouldn't be down here randomly. So, like, logically, the only place they can be is either in their base buying or on their way here. So either, like, right here, here, or here. And you don't have any armor, hardly. You know, you just have 65, which is a really low amount for 20 in the game. 20 minutes into the game. what you want to do here, I don't mind going for the hook, but I would not take it. To just land the hook, Ziggs will hit him with a bomb. You know, Lucian might throw a little damage on there. Other thing is you don't have your own people here. You've got Master Yi down here just goofing around. You've got Teemo splitting top. His teleport's not up. I mean, even if it was, he would be too late. You don't have good teleport wards here. So at best, you know, I would say this is going to be a 3-on-3 here. And you know they're not going to follow you up immediately to kill her because they're going to kill the tower. So I like hooking her here. Maybe even walking up and flaying her there. Like, hook her and just, like, naturally walk to right here and flay her. But I would not go all the way in there. That's just way too far when you have this many unknowns. Okay, so there's Talon. Now, Talon, if he was smart, he'd just blow you up immediately if he was paying attention to what you were building. But I'll guarantee you he thinks, Thresh is too tanky. I'm not going to attack Thresh, right? But if he just actually, like, full combos you here... you know, if he did his little blade thing and then jumped on you and then ulted and ignited you, you'd blow up instantly. And then they'd probably get to walk away without losing anything. But he's really greedy, I think, and he doesn't do that. Yeah, he runs. Yeah, so two of them were there. The hook. Then Janna rotated. Yeah, so y'all got pretty lucky. Talon didn't ignite anyone in there, and he didn't fight. Like, he could have vaporized you. He has so many kills. He had 9 kills. He had 8 kills when he showed up. So he just misplayed that. But yeah, you gotta look and keep that in mind. Like, you don't always have to take the hook. In fact, I think that's one of the biggest things that is really hard to do as Thresh, is to decide when you take the hook and when you don't. And when you're playing this kind of Enchanter Thresh, the answer is don't. Just don't take the hook hardly ever. Like, it's working out here because they're making a lot of mistakes. But I don't remember if I said this in this video, or I think it was in the last coaching video I did. You don't want to be results-oriented. So you don't just want to think, you know, it was a good play because it ended up well, right? Or it was a good idea because we ended up ahead, you know? And conversely, it's not necessarily a bad idea just because it didn't work out. Sometimes things just don't work out, even though they were good ideas. So you always want to think, like, be process-oriented. Does that make sense doing that? Like, was that the right type of thing to do there? And I think taking that hook, even though it kind of worked out, was not the right thing for the reasons I described. You're too squishy, you don't have vision on the enemy, and you know for certain two of your allies are not going to be there. So, even if three people show up there faster than they did, and they actually played it the way they should have played it, like, if Thresh just blew you up instantly, then they could have turned that whole fight around. But he just, like, ran away. Because he's not looking at your items. Yeah, get him out of there. Kill Janna. Run. I think. Be very careful with him. Okay, yeah, now you're going, Arden. If you're going to do this build, like I said, I don't recommend full-on Enchanter, but if you're going to do it, get the Arden first. It's a better first buy than Redemption is, and then get Redemption after it. Okay, that's a good play. Yeah, once again, let's look here. Look at what we know and what we don't know when y'all want to fight this, okay? Alright, so what do we know, what do we not know? Let me fast forward this until we get to where you are here. Where you're in the action. Okay, so you're pushing up, good. Alright, what do we know? Let's pause. Alright, Master Yi's over here, Kennen's over here. Kennen may or may not have teleport. Just assume he probably does. You know you don't have Master Yi, though. Okay. Okay, Janna's an easy kill, okay? She's isolated from everybody else. Good. Janna's a good pick. That was a good play. Okay, so Janna down. Master Yi is really crucial to your team, though. He's a lot of your damage output, and he's not there. And you know Kennen can be there, in theory, if he wants to be. Off of teleport. You see Talon here. You don't see anyone else, so we don't know where anyone else is. Okay, there's Nautilus. Talon does a lot of damage. You need to really keep an eye on him. I would just leave. You just got a kill. Okay. You missed it. Run. No, you're doing it again. Once you miss the hook, done. It's done. You don't have enough tools in your kit once you miss it. That's definitely a common theme that shows up, is I think you miss the hook and maybe you're frustrated with yourself and you just want to make the play anyways. You're like, I missed it, but whatever, I'm still going to make this play. You're forcing it too hard. Like, if you miss the hook, just back up at best and just reset. Because when you don't have your hook, it's a really big deal. And Master Yi wasn't there. And I think Ziggs was backing or something. Let me see. Did Ziggs just straight up back? Or did he die? Okay, Ziggs died in there. Teemo's at half health. Ziggs is dead. And you need to. And you missed your hook. So that's it. That's your chance. Okay, you missed the hook. If you land the hook, maybe. But I still don't like it. Because you're missing Ziggs. You're missing Yi. Kennen could show up if he wanted to. They're missing Janna, but whatever. Yeah. So yeah, definitely, like, did I have that down? Okay, let me write that down really quick. Because that's something that's happened, like, three times here. Blue team's turret has been destroyed. K Kenan also got two towers off of that quietly. So, you know, that's another thing. It's like, you got to think, what are y'all going to do here? Right? Are you going to be able to take this tower? Because Kenan's taking top lane uncontested right now. So unless you can push these towers faster against, you know, three people, unless you think you can push those towers faster than Kenan can push it in an open lane, then you don't want to do it. Which, you're not going to be able to do that. Especially not with Ziggs dead. So the kills really don't matter as much as towers do. Okay, you need to get some more wards out. What do we got here? What'd you buy? Okay, yeah, Ardent. I think that's just too bold with an 11 kill Talon, and I think you need an armor item at least one. I like Ziggs here. If you want to buff your team, just get, or not Ziggs, Zeke's. Yeah, he just melted you. Okay, let me look again. Let's count again before you go this way. And you need to do this every time you want to engage. Just take like a second and a half to look at your mini-map and just count the dots. Just see where the dots are. Just look at the colors. That's step one, is just look at the colors and see. Say, okay, what do I know? What do I not know? You don't have a lot of vision on the enemy. You don't have a lot of wards down, so you're not going to know a lot about them, but you're going to know about you, and you have to go with what you know. Okay? You know Janna's there. You know nobody is here. You have no vision here. You know they want to probably be around Baron. Okay? Janna's there. It's unlikely Janna would be there by herself. She could be. But she's probably... Why would she ward this, is what you want to think. Why would she go in here and do this? It's because they want to set up for Baron, right? And so that's why she's going in there. So that means there's probably going to be more people in this area. Okay? Okay, good. You hit Janna. But Lucian's out of this fight. He's too far away. Teemo's not that close. You have no eyes on anybody. Anywhere in here. So you need to be assuming that either there are two or three people like right here doing raptors or running this way, or there are two or three people right here, like maybe running through this way. Maybe they were going to go pick off Teemo and they see you instead and like curve and come down here. Let's do a, just really quickly, let's just look at the map and see how close I am. Okay, kind of close. So there's two people. So Talon is actually flanking because you didn't have any vision middle, so he got around here behind you. And Nautilus is about where I said someone was going to be, near raptors. Kenan's actually back. He does have teleport, but I'm pretty close. There are two or three people close to you right now, and your allies are not. So your allies, Lucian is further away than Nautilus is. And it's just you and Yi right now. Teemo's not here. Where's Ziggs is still dead. Okay. Done. Analysis done. I didn't even notice that Ziggs was dead. Okay, so Ziggs is just straight up dead. So you can't fight. Because you have no clue where they are. And the best case, it's probably going to be a 4v5. You know, maybe if one of them's missing, it's a 4v4 if you're lucky. But yeah, Ziggs is straight dead. So you can't fight it at that point. You know, you can't. Even though it looks like Janna's alone, you know she's not though, because you see Xayah. And just with this logic, you know that they're probably going to be here, right? So you don't have to go through all of these steps. All you really have to do is just notice that Ziggs is dead. And just ward this area and wait. That's it. Just don't fight. Yeah, it's looking all good until everybody shows up, right? And you know, the old argument that people give that I hear in my games, and this happens at, I'm not sure what level this is at, this kind of stuff even happens in like plat, even in low diamond, honestly, is that people will say, oh, well, I didn't know they were there. It's like, but you should have, you know, like you gotta give them credit. You gotta respect darkness. You gotta see the unseen. So if you don't know where they are, there's a good chance they're near you. This is why vision is so important. Because, yeah, like, you can make that play even with Ziggs, if Ziggs is dead, if you have vision. So if you have a ward here and, like, here and over here, if if you have this all warded up and you know there's nobody within 15 seconds of that play, sure, go for it, because you have vision. But if you don't have vision and you don't know where they are, you have to respect that they could be there. So it makes you play a lot more defensively if you don't have vision. Or you should be playing more defensively if you don't have vision. Okay, back up. You missed it all. You missed it all. Leave. That is the number one thing I want you to work on right now, is if you miss, leave. Let it go. Just don't do it. You're like, it is working out this game, right? Sort of. You know, your team is converting on a lot of this stuff. But in general, if you miss the play, there's no shame. I miss hooks all the time as Thresh. There's no shame in missing a hook on Thresh. Okay? But you gotta be real about it. You gotta say, you know what? I'm missing a very important tool in my toolkit. And I've just gotta wait until it's off cooldown. Because once they see you miss that, they can get a lot more aggressive. Because they know you're gonna be missing one of your big tools. Okay, you need to leave. You don't have vision. You need to get vision. Put some wards here. Even if you can't get perfect vision, just like, do you have wards in your inventory? Yeah, you got 4 wards. Just drop them. Like, just drop, like, even though you have a ward here, why not just drop one here, drop one here, drop one over this wall? Just put wards on the map. Just, even if they're not ideal wards, just make sure there are always 3 wards on the map. And a good trick is whenever you run somewhere, if you have wards in your inventory, just drop wards. Okay, so y'all kind of lucked out there. Yi's just really strong. They don't have, you know, and they're really split up. Yeah, if all 5 of them had been there with Nautilus, they could have cleaned y'all up. Let me see your back timing. I think maybe you should have just rotated a dragon instead of backing. Yeah, it's up in, what, 10 seconds? Yeah, don't back. You're full health. You have 4 wards. What'd you buy? Let me see what you bought. If you completed, like, a huge ticket item. If you just buy, like, a control ward or something, no way. Yeah, you just... That's not worth it. Like, Aegis is okay, but it's better to be on time for Dragon, because, you know, they go for this fight, and Ziggs gets some good poke here, but there are only 3 people here. We know Teemo's top. Teemo doesn't have teleport. You can see that by tabbing. Lucian's gonna be late, but, like, I think you just saw Nautilus middle, but, like, what happens if, you know, Yi comes running in here, and then Kennen just, like, flashes over this wall and ults. And then Zaya does, like, Featherstorm and just, like, obliterates everybody. You know? So you need to make sure that you're there with your team for these dragons on time. Like, you need to be looking at the timer and say, oh, man, you know, you need to prepare, like, a minute early. But even if you can't get there a minute early and put up all the wards you need to put up, at least look down here and see it's a yellow hourglass when you want to back and say, oh, crap, I better go help them with that, and then rotate down there, especially if you still have wards in your inventory. Just roam down here, just run through middle, ward this, and just, like, ward here or here. Just drop all your wards and help them get the dragon. Okay. So it works out, because it turns out they actually are alone this time for some reason, and their Talon's top. So, you know, they goofed that up pretty badly. Talon's, like, getting golems or killing Teemo instead of getting dragons. So that's really potentially what lost them the game right there, is Talon not being there. But you don't want to put it in their hands, right? You don't want to count on Talon being out of position, right? You want to be there and just assume he's going to be there and be ready to help your team. Okay, so I'm going to say... writing down respect darkness and rotate to objectives on time. Okay. Okay, Talon just lost his mind. Lantern him out. Okay, y'all gotta run. Run. Get out. Get out. Okay. This is such a fiesta. Everyone's just running around randomly. Master Yi's very good at that, though. I mean, he really preys on people, like, not, you know, grouping around him. Okay. He has lifesteal, he doesn't have armor. You don't have armor either. I mean, this is a problem, like, if you don't have armor, like, you could have tanked Baron. How low was Baron getting? Like, you could have tanked Baron if you had armor. So if you had, like, a Zeke's or something, you could have tanked Baron. Yeah, you don't have enough vision. Like, you need more vision around here so that you... Talon's bottom. That's iffy. I feel like y'all could have done it. Certainly, if you had vision, you could have done it. So if you, like, warded here and warded over here. So when you were running around here and, like, Lucian, you know, you threw a hook at Lucian or whatever, just drop a ward here. Drop a ward over this. Like, just drop wards as you walk around. And if you had more vision there, then I think you could have just kept doing there. And if you knew it was only Janna, because you saw Talon bottom. Back away from him, he can kill you. Yeah, I would leave him alone. So, like, after he does that, just back away, and if you want to throw a hook at him or something, fine, but I would not just sit there in melee combat. You're just giving him a free, like, auto attack Q on you. Okay, I like the redemption. Or not the redemption, the locket. Okay, she just... Yeah, this is a problem when you don't close out games, like... Sometimes your player, like, the person who's fed just goes into hero mode, and they just... start trying to 1v3. And throw games. God. Ziggs is doing so much work here. Yeah, you got a ward. You got a ward, man. You got a ward right at Kennen. Okay, Lucian warded, but you got to watch out for Kennen. If Kennen comes rolling up and, like, ults into this... Step up. You got to step up more. And this is where that lack of armor is really hurting you. Okay. Ooh, that's scary. There he is. He was just, like, 5 seconds too late. Yeah, you have to get wards in here, man. You gotta get these wards down. I mean, you bought the sightstone, which is good, but you gotta put the wards down. Even if they're not perfect, even if you just ward over this wall, you know? Just get a little more vision just anywhere. Ward here, ward, like, over here. Just anything that gives you vision. Just have them down on the map. Like, the most important thing is to always have wards on the map. If they're not in the perfect spot, fine. You can work on that later. But step one is just always have wards on the map, even if they're not ideal. I think you're following too many hooks for your itemization. Like, you can take those kind of hooks if you, you know, have 3,000 health and, like, 200 armor or something, you know? You can take those hooks. But you can't take them as, like, a Thresh with only 2,600 health and, like, 100 armor at this point in the game. Zaya's just gonna absolutely melt you. So, like, you know, if you'd itemized into, Face of the Mountain, Knight's Vow, or something like that, then sure, you could make those kind of plays. But as someone who has itemized this utility path, you really have to play like a utility champion. Just land the hook, it's good crowd control, maybe even flay if they're close enough, but do not take the hook over there. It's going to be a one-way ticket to death a lot of the time. Especially against like 19 kill Talon, like he can one-shot you. And Zaya's pretty, like, her score doesn't look great, but she still does a lot of damage. Okay, let me reduce this. I'm gonna say, don't take hooks with Enchanter build. Like I said, I don't mind Ardent Censor, but I think that Redemption, as of the current patch, is pushing it a little bit. But if you want to do it, it's still viable. You got to play around it. Like, you can't be as aggressive. Wait, hold on. Let me get this again. Was this another case of Hookitis? Okay, so once again, look on the mini. You guys really shouldn't even be fighting this. You have two people that aren't here. If they just, like, roll down on you with five people, it's going to be a huge problem. Please don't take this. No! No! Oh. Come on, my friend. So y'all cleaned it up, but once again, the reason that I'm like, no, because I know something bad's going to happen here, because once again, like I keep saying, y'all don't have vision, you have no idea where anyone is, they're not clearing this lane, they're not split pushing. The only place, and they know dragon's up, you know at least one of them is there. There's no Baron, there's no red buff, there's no blue buff. Like, literally the only places they could logically be on this map. I mean, I guess someone could be farming golems or something in theory, but they're either backed or they're going to be like here. So they're somewhere between here and here, right? They are running. So you don't know where they are because you don't have vision. Once again, if you had vision here, if you set this up and you had vision here and vision here, maybe you could follow that hook. I still would be skeptical because unless, like, if you have vision here, here, and like over here, like you completely see everything in their jungle, then sure, take it. But right now you don't know. You just don't know where they are. And logically, it makes sense that they would be in this area. What you do know, however, is that Lucian's over here doing wolves or something. Zig's just randomly backed. So, you know, it's going to be a three versus whatever shows up here. That's why I wouldn't even do the dragon, honestly. I would just like try to zone them off and just wait on these other two people to show up. But you got away with it. You did it. So you need to run. Like, get out. Nautilus, look. I mean, look at Nautilus's positioning, too. Why would he cut back in here when Dragon's done? Just think about it logically. Why would he double back if he didn't have backup, right? Like, he was looking to hook you. Right? If we go back and just watch his movements. You know that's warded, because they just warded it. You see Janna here. Okay. Cleared mushrooms. You see Zaya here. Okay, so you know they're like around here. You know they're in the area. Now watch this. Okay, so why on earth would he double back for a ward there if they weren't coming? You know? Like, if it was just him and for some reason he was just wandering down here, he would run like immediately if he saw five people and Dragon died. He's out of there, right? There's no way he's sticking around if he doesn't have backup. Okay, so you see him double back. Yeah. So Zig saves the day again with a really clutch bomb. This Zig is doing some serious work this game. Pwned. Okay, so once again, this is why I'm saying you can't be results-oriented, because it worked out, but this Ziggs is just, like, throwing some miracle ultimates here. Like, that's what won that fight. That Ziggs ult knocked, like, half the health off of four people. So, yeah, I mean, I feel you. Once you land the hook, you just want to go in, and it looks like, oh, man, it's just Nautilus. We caught him out. Like, I've got, you know, I've got backup. I've got two people here. You know, we can do this, but... You know, three people against five is going to be a hard time, even with the Yi that's at Fed. So yeah, back up. Yeah, go pressure top. What'd you buy? So it's got the chain vest. Okay. I assume you're probably going something like Knight's Vow. Yeah, you need vision. So in here, a good place to ward is over this wall. Okay, this is not bad. Yeah, just hide out here. Ziggs, get in the bush. No, you're too far. You're too far ahead of everybody. You're gonna get killed by Zaya. Yeah. You can't be that far ahead. Like, you gotta play back near your AD carry. Lucian wasn't even there, right? Again. Yeah, y'all can't do this. You can't do it. Lucian's here. Teemo's here. Should they be up there? Yes, but they're not. So y'all are opting into a potentially a 3v5 again. I know you don't see all of them these times, so you don't. Maybe you don't think they're going to be there. They're going to be there because there's nowhere else to be. Like, they're not clearing this wave. They're not clearing that wave. This is the only logical place they can be is all together. And yeah, these minions are doing some work on their tower. But yeah, once again, y'all got baited into trying to pick somebody off who looked like they were alone, but you didn't have proper vision coverage, and so they're not alone. So you have to respect it. If you don't have the vision, you just can't do it. Like, you needed a vision, you needed a ward here, and you probably needed a ward like around here. And just wait. Just wait on Lucian. Just count the dots. Like, the easiest thing on the screen is just count the dots. And just make sure that you have more dots than they could possibly have. And that's when you fight. Okay, yeah. I've talked about that several times. Okay. So, good. I mean, you hit some really clutch hooks. You had some great plays in lane. I like that. It's just working on kind of that mid game and just understanding the build that you've opted into. Once again, if you... go for, like, you know, something like Knight's Vow, Locket, Zeke's, maybe even Warmogs, you know, just something like that that makes you really tanky, then you can be on the front line, you know, a little bit more, trying to disrupt Zaya and, you know, whatever. But I think the best place to be is back near your AD carry, just trying to peel, right? So just land those hooks, don't take them, and then just save your flay when they try to dive in, when Talon tries to go in, flay him back, ult him, and just go from there. So just use your hooks just to crowd control people, let Ziggs get a little poke on them, just let other people kill them. Just there were so many times where you were too far forward, because Zaya just kills you. And the thing is, you're going to get hit by collateral damage if you do that. You always want to avoid that as a support. So if they have area of effect stuff, you do not want to get hit with it. So that's why you want to stand like far in the back and kind of spread out. Because right now, the way you're positioning, Zaya's going to hit you with her feathers for free, even if she's aiming them at Yi or Lucian or whatever, she's going to hit you because you're just kind of in the middle of everything. Kennen's just going to hit you with every ult. Talon's going to hit you when his blades go out and with all this other stuff. So all of these people are going to get free damage on you without aiming specifically for you. If they want to hit you, you want to make them like aim for you, not get free damage on you while they're killing somebody else. So that's why you want to position towards the back a little bit more so that you avoid all of that collateral area of effect damage that's not intended for you but nevertheless is killing you. Okay. So we're going to say in laning phase, lead early with E plus Q. So try to hit your flay first and then go for the Q early on. It makes it easier to land. Later on you can't do that as easily because they'll just you know, you'll take too much damage trying to get into position to E. But, like, at level 2, you can afford to do it. They're not going to put that much damage on you while you're trying that out. So when Lucian tries to go back in with, like, 30% HP, you want to ping him back. Just say, no, dude, no. No, 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 no. I missed my hook. Like, Zaya just hit us with all these feathers. We just need to back up and chill. Like, do not press forward. Do not try to push it when it's a losing trade. So just back up, chill, wait for a reset, ping your AD carry to back. And just run if an ally pings you back, just no matter what. Just ask questions later, just say, why'd you ping me back? You know, it's better to run and not need to run if an ally pings you than to not run and give up kills, okay? Because what's going to happen if you run and you don't need to? You might lose some experience from, like, one or two minions, you know. It's much, much better. Because just assume people aren't going to ping you for no reason. Unless it's a troll, then that's a different story. But they're not going to ping you if they don't think there's a good reason. So that means that they either saw somebody straight up or someone left their lane, like Talon walked out of vision and is probably on the way. Just listen to people and just say, you know what, if ally pings you back, just run. Just say, they probably saw something. I'm going to respect that. I'm going to run. Because Talon could have rotated on you early. He didn't. You guys came to him, and he got a bunch of kills, but he could have been. So you want to make sure that you check that out. Okay, the other one is check minimap before engage. This is a huge one. So once again, if you had better vision coverage, you could know where they are. So you could say, okay, like, I know one of them is on the other side of the map doing some jungle camp. I know the other one is at this place. We have four people here, so I know we can go, right? So even though we're missing one core person, I know we can make this play because I know where two of them are, right? But if you don't have vision, then you have to go off of what you know, which is your team. You have to respect what you don't know. So you have to say, okay, we're missing two people here. We see one person split pushing top lane, but we don't know where the other four people are, so we have to assume that the four people are probably in this area, and so we can't go in, because it would be 3v4. So that's just kind of the mentality that you have to have, is you have to err on the side of caution when you don't have vision. Yeah, I mean, that happened a lot. That happened a lot. So just make sure that you kind of, you know, tie that up a little bit. And it's simple. Just look. You don't even have to think that critically about it. Just look at the colors on the map, right? Just look at it and just say, are my allies here? No? Okay, don't fight. Unless you see that enemies also are not there. Okay, so you don't even have to do all the calculus of like, well, Yi is this fed, he has this many items, so he might be able to kill these people fast enough, so maybe we could do this kind of fight. No, like, that's true. You know, you did win some of these imbalanced fights because Yi was so fed and Ziggs was hitting good bombs, but you don't want to count on that. And you're not going to have time, probably, as you're sort of learning this, to do those calculations in your head accurately, right? And so just go by just the basic stuff, just number of dots, right? So do you have more allies than they have enemies in a fight? Okay, fight. No, don't fight. All right. The other one is don't take hooks unless you itemize tanky, because you're just going to be dying a lot and you're potentially going to rope your team into a really bad fight. So I know as Thresh you want to take the hook and then flay, but really you're not adding that much more to the situation a lot of the times when you go in and flay. Like, yeah, you're crowd controlling them a little bit more, but often you're pulling yourself very far out of position and you're going to take a lot of free hits before your allies can respond. Now, sometimes that's not a bad thing if you're really tanky, because you can get on there and just like disrupt a bunch of people with your ultimate, and maybe they use some cooldowns on you and you walk away free and you're just a huge distraction to buy time for your enemy to engage. It doesn't work if you're squishy though, because you're just going to go in, flay them, and they're going to blow you up in like 2 seconds before your allies can even do anything. So it makes sense as a tank to start a fight, distract the enemy team, draw some cooldowns, and then the rest of your team could clean them up as you survive. But you can't do it with your itemization that you chose. So that itemization is okay. I don't particularly endorse it, but I understand it can work. But you need to play that style. You need to play the Janna type of... If you're going to build like Janna, you need to kind of play like Janna, right? You just have a hook instead of a tornado. So you need to use that hook to kind of start fights and displace people, and then hang out in the back and use your flay primarily to disengage, you know, throw lanterns to help people reposition, and use your ultimate as a peeling tool. So Thresh can do that and be successful. So you can work that build, but you just have to play to the items. You have to decide, okay, that's how I'm going to play this game. Okay, so if you miss your hook, just back up. Don't force a fight if you're missing core cooldowns. So if you're missing your ult, if you're missing your hook, things like that, try not to fight. Just wait until you have those things up again. This kind of fits in with earlier, put it in here, just respect darkness. So once again, I didn't have colors on the minimap. I just knew that there were going to be people there just kind of logically, right, a lot of these times, because they couldn't be anywhere else. So I didn't even have the map hacks turned on. It's just... I could kind of see that. It's better if you can have the map hacks on, if you have wards out so you can actually see them without having to make these assumptions. But if you don't, you just have to err on the side of caution. Okay, so with that dragon, you chose to go back and get like a control ward instead of rotating a dragon. Ideally, you would have gone back earlier, bought your stuff, been there, you know, like 30 seconds early, and then warded everything, killed the scuttle, put a control ward on the dragon, and just shut him out. Just make sure you secure that dragon. But if you don't have time for that, at least be there. So rotate when it's silver or yellow. Rotate and make sure that you're going to be ready when it pops so that you're there with your team. I'm ready for a good fight. Okay, that's going to be it. Thank you very much. I really appreciate the donation. I hope this helps. Yeah, you played a really nice laning phase. You did hit some really good hooks in there. You made some great plays. I think, you know, a lot of it is just maybe some choices with itemization. Like I said, it can work, but you have to, matching your itemization with the playstyle you want to play, I think would be the best place to put it. So you want to make sure that that's ready. And then just respecting darkness, just assuming they're going to be there, just counting the dots on the minimap. And yeah, should Lucian be there more? Should Ziggs be there more? Absolutely, they should ward. They should rotate faster, but they're not. So you just have to work with what you have. If your enemies are out of position, you just can't make some plays. You just got to wait. And sometimes that sucks when you have a really good opportunity, but you just got to play with what you have. You got to play with the hand you're dealt. So you can't always get aces. Sometimes you're going to get that 2-7 off suit. You just got to try to figure out how to win with it. But anyways, that's going to be it. Thank you very much. Hope everyone enjoyed it. And thanks again for the donation. And I'll see you all next time. Have a good one.